management. But Century Plywood posted a decent set of earnings in the fourth quarter as the MDF margins stood out, but the plywood margins were weak. Keshav Bhajanka, the executive director of Century Plywood, joins us on the show to talk about that. Mr. Bhajanka, thanks so much for joining us. You know, the plywood margins have been under pressure. In fact, in Q1, it's just a 12% margin that you've seen versus an average of 15-16% that you saw same time last year. Is there more pressure on the cards, and how is business generally?
The plywood margin in Q1 was actually 14.5%. So it had rebounded considerably from Q4 of last year, and we are expecting margins to be within the 14% range this year. So last year Q1 was an exceptional quarter for us, which was a very high EBITDA quarter. That was because most of the marketing expenses were deferred to later quarters. But I think 14% plus is sustainable EBITDA margins for us in the plywood business, and this year we will be at 14% plus.
Okay. You know, obviously your MDF and laminates have done a little better than plywood. Would you be changing the mix? Is there a market for MDF more than plywood?
You see, what has happened is in Q1, there's a lot of pressure on plywood on account of players undercutting and reducing prices, because of which volume increase for us was difficult. However, we decided that we would not be risking EBITDA margins, and we would be trying to maintain price at the cost of maybe increasing in volume. Alongside that, our veneer division, which used to contribute substantially to the plywood division, reduced in size considerably because of the ban in export of timber from Myanmar and from Laos, and certain problems with the same. This year, we are going to be increasing our footprint. We are going to be investing in Gabon, which will start operation in Q4, which will give us a growth in the veneer division. As far as plywood is concerned, yes, we'd definitely be looking at 14% plus margins, but the growth is looking muted. We are looking at maybe 7-8% growth for the entire year on account of high single digit growth for the rest of the year. In laminates, we are definitely looking at a 15% plus growth for the entire year. Alongside that, we are looking at a slight uptake in margins from 9% last year to close to 11% this year. MDF definitely looks like a very high growth segment for the current year. We will be looking to grow at 20% plus, and we will be looking to maintain 20% plus EBITDA margins.
7% in plywood, I mean, the first quarter has been only 1%. What makes you so confident?
You see, in the first quarter, we had the option of increasing volumes by slashing prices, because competitors had reduced prices substantially, which I'm sure will reflect in the earnings. But we decided that we don't want to risk our margins by reducing prices for one quarter just for the sake of volume. So I am sure that this reduction in prices is not sustainable. So when we are closer to a level playing field in the following quarters, I'm sure we'll be able to increase in volumes.
But you spoke about competitor undercutting and why, you know, that's the reason why the results were under pressure. Do you think that FY20 for the plywoods business could be a low single digit volume year? I mean, in Q1 your volumes in plywood just grew about 1%. Are we looking at single digit growth for the full year?
Yes, we are looking at a single digit growth, mid to high single digit growth. So we will be looking at anything between 7-8%.
You know, the other problem, actually you're facing two problems and you discussed both. The demand is an issue, but undercutting is also an issue, which is very clear in MDF. You think there you may lose margins even further?
So in MDF, we have actually increased margins substantially in this quarter. This quarter, I believe we are at 23% plus EBITDA margins, which is far higher than anything that we hit last year. Now, the reason behind the same is the pressure on prices was due to the fact that there was a lot of excess capacity and demand had not grown in line with the same. This year, demand is increasing rapidly, and as such, pressure on prices has reduced considerably. In Q1, we have actually taken a price increase. So I don't think in MDF there's going to be pressure on pricing. Now it is a game of capacity utilization, and I believe with higher capacity utilization, we'll be able to maintain 20% plus margins going forward.
You're actually saying demand improved in MDF?
Yes, substantially. Within the North India, which is our primary market, within Q1, the demand for MDF has increased substantially. The overall growth in the market, by my estimate, would be around 25% plus.
good to hear. I was only surprised because very few people have spoken of improved demand for any product. So it's good to hear. Sorry.
No, I wanted to. You briefly mentioned that you raised prices in MDF. For how much was the price hike that you undertook? And will you be making any more price changes?
We took a price hike of about 3% plus towards the mid of June. And I think that this for now looks like the stable pricing in the market. We will see if there's scope for further price increases going forward. But as you know, it is a highly competitive market. So it depends on competitor action as well.
Can you just give us an integrated guidance in terms of revenue and margin?
Okay, so segment wise in plywood, like I've already mentioned, we'd be looking at 7 to 8% growth for the year. Margins would look at about 14% EBITDA margins. In laminates, we'd be looking at 15% plus growth this year with EBITDA margins of anything in excess of 11%. Okay. In MDF, we'd be looking at 20% growth for the current year with EBITDA margins of about 20% plus. Okay. In particle board, again, we'd be looking at 20% growth with a beta margin of 25% plus.
Okay, that's a very optimistic guidance. And just for the benefit of our viewers, MDF stands for medium density fiber board, which is generally used, it's a type of hard board which is used to make display cabinets, wall panels, etc.
Your kitchen cabinets don't have MDF. We have MDF all over in our house.
I know. But sometimes these acronyms, you don't suddenly realize what they mean. All right, Keshav, thanks so much for joining us and giving us your views. That Century Plyboards, actually that's a big up move that you're seeing in the stock, post a decent set of numbers. By the way, Bharat Forge has just come out with an update.